نعم اركع الآن.
going to record.
لا تفرض هكذا يقول. نعم. وتقطع الرأس. يعني المرفقين الآن غير مثنية.
So we can see how the elbows are not bending. They're not bending out.
يعني لا يثني المرفقين.
So a person should not bend his elbows.
حتى ويكون الظهر على استقامة واحدة مع الرأس.
And we can see that the back is parallel and level to the head.
فعندما يثني المرفقين ينثني الظهر.
So whenever a person bends his elbows,
عندما ثنى هنا ثنى الظهر.
So as soon as you've bended your elbows, then your naturally your body or your head will also come down.
فأجعل الرأس والظهر على استقامة واحدة مع المرفقين.
So therefore, the elbows have to be straight, the arm has to be straight, and the back and the head are level.
نعم. الآن وهو راكع بين الركوع وبين الاعتدال القيام يرفع اليدين مع قول سمع الله لمن حمده.
And now, whilst he's in ruku', between getting up from the ruku' and fully standing up, he raises his hands and at the same time he says سمع الله لمن حمده.
الآن يرفع يقول سمع الله لمن حمده. مع رفع اليدين فاذا استقام هنا يقول ربنا ولك الحمد.
So whilst he is in the transition from ruku' to fully standing up, he says سمع الله لمن حمده and he raises his hands. As soon as he stands up and he's upright, then he says ربنا ولك الحمد.
كثير من الناس يقول رب سمع الله لمن حمده اذا استقام هنا. هذا خطا. لابد ان يقول سمع الله لمن حمده بين الركوع وبين القيام.
So many people, they say سمع الله لمن حمده after they have stood up, and this is a mistake. سمع الله لمن حمده has to be said whilst you are in the transition of standing up.
الآن إذا استقام يقول ربنا ولك الحمد.
So when he is now upright and fully standing up, he says ربنا ولك الحمد.
ويستحب له أن يزيد بما ورد عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And it is recommended for him to increase in the remembrances according to that which has been narrated from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
كان يقول,
like for example, he says,
لربي الحمد لربي الحمد لربي الحمد أو حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه. نعم.
Like he says these remembrances.
ثم بعد هذا يسجد.
And then after this he goes into sujood.
نعم. يضع باطن الأصابع على الأرض وأصابع الرجلين إلى القبلة ويضم عقبين.
So a person, whilst making sujood, his feet should be close together, and the bottom of his feet should be on the floor, and his toes are pointing towards the qibla.
نعم. ويضع الكفين حذو الأذنين أو المنكبين.
And also he places his hands to the level of his shoulders or parallel to his ears.
والأعضاء السبعة لابد أن تكون على الأرض.
And the seven limbs should be touching the earth, or touching the floor.
الجبهة والأنف,
the forehead and the nose.
وباطن الكفين,
and the palms of the two hands.
والركبتين,
the two knees.
وباطن أصابع الرجلين,
and also the bottom of the feet, or the bottom of the toes.
أكثر ما يكون خلل عندنا في السجود.
Most of the mistakes which occur in the prayer are usually in the sujood.
يرفع الأصابع, لا يضع باطن أصابع, يضع هكذا.
So for example, a person, he props up his toes instead of placing his toes upon the earth.
أو يرفع الرجلين.
Or he raises his feet.
أو يضع إحداهما على الأخرى.
Or he places one foot on the other.
نعم. أو يضع هكذا أطراف الأصابع.
نعم.
نعم. لابد من وضع باطن الأصابع على الأرض وأصابع الرجلين إلى القبلة.
So a person has to make sure that his feet and the bottom of his toes are actually touching the earth and facing towards the qibla.
أيضا من الأخطاء في السجود,
also from the errors in sujood,
أن ينضم, ينضم هكذا, ينضم,
is that a person, this is from the mistakes of the prayer, that he makes sujood and his body is very compact and tight.
إلا عند الضرورة,
except in a state of necessity.
أو يمتد كأنه نائم.
Oh, a person, he stretches out so much so that it's as if he's sleeping.
نعم. لابد أن يجافي, يباعد بين أشياء ثلاثة.
So a person has to ensure that there is distance between three things.
بين الساق والفخذ.
between
his الساق والفخذ.
Between his thighs and the back of his legs, there has to be a distance.
وبين البطن والفخذ.
And between a person's stomach and his thighs.
وهنا عند الإبط.
And also his armpits, or the side of his body.
نعم. ويجعل الأصابع مضمومة جهة القبلة كما صنع في الرفع في تكبيرة الإحرام.
And also a person he ensures his hands or his fingers are together facing the way of the قبلة.
أيضا من الأخطاء أن يضع المرفقين على الأرض.
From the mistakes is for a person to place his elbows upon the earth.
وضع المرفقين على الأرض. نعم. اجلس الآن. ماذا يقول في سجوده؟
What should a person say whilst he's in his sujood?
يقول وجوبا بهذا اللفظ سبحان ربي الأعلى لابد مرة واحدة.
A person has to say as an obligation سبحان ربي الأعلى at least once as an obligation.
يستحب له أن يزيد بما ورد عن النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام.
And then it is recommended for him to increase in this according to what has been narrated from the Prophet.
نعم. وله أن يدعو بما أحب والأولى أن يدعو بما ورد عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And he is able to make dua to supplicate with anything that he wants to supplicate with. But it is more recommended for a person to supplicate with those supplications which are found in the Quran and the Sunnah.
ثم بعد هذا يكبر ويجلس.
And then after this, after making sujood, he says Allahu Akbar and he sits down. How do you see?
أي نعم. نعم. يجعل يجلس على افرش الرجل اليسرى ويجلس عليها وينصب اليمنى ويجعل باطن اصابع اليمنى الى القبلة.
So when
باطن اصابع اليمنى على الارض والاصابع اليمنى الى القبلة.
So when a person after sujood he says Allahu Akbar and he sits between the two sujood. And whilst he is sitting he sits on his left foot and he props up his right foot ensuring that the toes of his right foot are facing towards the Qibla.
وأطراف الأصابع عند نهاية الفخذ أول الركبة.
And the tips of his fingers are at the beginning of the knee.
هذا الجلوس في جلسات الصلاة كلها.
So this manner of sitting is in every position of the prayer in which a sitting is required.
إلا في التشهد الأخير إذا كان في الصلاة أكثر من تشهد في الصلاة الثلاثية كالمغرب أو الرباعية كالظهر والعصر والعشاء يتورك في التشهد الأخير.
And the only exception is in the prayers where there is more than one تشهد like the three ركعات of المغرب or the four ركعات of عشاء وعصر in which there are two تشهد in the final تشهد he can change his sitting.
تخرج هذا الرجل من هنا.
So in the second tashahud, when there is more than one tashahud in the prayer, then a person can sit like this.
نعم يقبض على ركبته اليسرى ويشير بالإصبع.
So a person he grabs hold of his left knee with his left hand and with his right hand he's raising his finger pointing.
الأخطاء في الجلوس.
So the mistakes that people make while sitting.
نعم خليه يجلس يعدل رجليه. نعم الأخطاء أن يجعل الرجل هكذا.
So people the mistakes that they make while they're sitting is placing their right foot like this and are not propping it up.
أو يجلس على الرجلين.
Or that a person sits on both of his feet. This is also a mistake.
أو هكذا.
Or he sits like that.
أو يجعل الرجلين من الخارج ويجلس.
Or a person sits on the floor whilst his feet are to the side.
أي نعم ممكن هكذا أخطاء.
So all of these are mistakes.
أو يبعدهما ويجلس على عقبيه. نعم.
Or a person sits on the floor.
هذه الأخطاء في الجلوس. نعم.
All of these are mistakes when it comes to the prayer.
طيب. ثم بعد هذا يسجد.
After this, a person says Allahu Akbar, goes back into sujood.
ثم يقوم للركعة الثانية.
And then a person stands up once again for the second standing of the prayer.
يصنع فيها كما صنع في الأولى.
And he should pray in exactly the same manner in which he has prayed before.
لكن الثانية ليس فيها تكبيرة الإحرام، فيها تكبيرة انتقال من السجود إلى القيام.
But the only difference is that the takbir you have made now of standing up from the sujood isn't takbiratul ihram, because takbiratul ihram is a takbir which is made to start and initiate the prayer. This is not takbiratul intiqal, meaning the takbir to move from one position to another position. And also there is no dua for opening the prayer. This is only at the beginning. Like you said for the prayer.
نعم. فإذا انتهى من الثانية جلس للتشهد.
So if a person now finishes from his second unit of the prayer, he now sits for a tashahud. The sitting of التشهد.
ويشير بإصبعه.
And he points with his finger.
يحركها.
And he moves his finger.
نعم. ويقرأ التشهد كاملا.
And he reads or recites all of the tashahud.
ثم يصلي الصلاة الإبراهيمية على النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام.
And then after this he sends salutations upon the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم by saying الصلاة الإبراهيمية.
ثم يستعين بالله من أربع.
And then a person seeks refuge in Allah from four matters.
من عذاب جهنم.
From the punishment of Jahannam.
وعذاب القبر.
And the punishment of the grave.
ومن فتنة المحيا والممات.
And from the trials of life and death.
ومن فتنة المسيح الدجال.
And the trials and tribulations of الدجال.
ويستحب له أن يدعو بما أحب والأولى أن يدعو بأدعية النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام.
And after all of this, it is recommended for him to supplicate with any supplication that he wants. But it is recommended that he uses the supplications of the Quran and the Sunnah.
ثم يسلم برأسه فقط عن يمين السلام عليكم ورحمة الله ثم السلام عليكم ورحمة الله عن شماله.
And then he finishes his prayer by making taslim, but only with his head, meaning he only moves his head towards the right and then he faces the left.
الأخطاء في التسليم.
So people make mistakes when it comes to التسليم.
ينحرف قليلا عن اليمين هكذا وقليلا عن اليسار.
That a person, instead of fully facing with his head towards the right and the left, he'll only move it slightly towards the right and slightly towards the left.
أو يحرف يطقطق برأسه هكذا عن اليمين ثم يطقطق برأسه هكذا عن الشمال.
Or a person, he nods his head to whilst pointing it towards the right and he nods his head whilst pointing it towards the left.
أو يحرك يديه عن اليمين ويديه عن اليسار أو يضرب بهما.
Or some people when they move their hands as well.
أو يسلم بمنكبي.
Or a person, he makes taslim with all of his shoulders and his body.
نعم لا يسلم إلا برأسه فقط لا بمنكبي يعني ما ينحرف عن القبلة.
So a person should remain towards the direction of the qibla and he only faces his face towards the right and the left, not his shoulders.
هذا في الصلاة الثنائية كصلاة الفجر.
So this is the in the prayer in which there are only two rak'at, like the prayer of Fajr.
أما لو كان في الرباعية كالظهر يتشهد.
And as for the prayers in which there are four rak'at, four units of prayer, then he says that the tashahhud in the second sitting.
ويستحب له أن يأتي بالصلاة الإبراهيمية على النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام.
And then it is recommended for him to say a Salat al-Ibrahimiyya.
ثم يقوم.
And then he stands up once again for now the third unit of prayer.
ثم الآن إذا قام يرفع يديه قائلا الله أكبر.
And when a person stands up from the first sitting, i.e. the second unit of prayer, then he raises his hands saying Allahu Akbar.
يتمها ثم بعد هذا يجلس للتشهد.
And then he completes his third unit and all the fourth unit. And he sits back down for the final tashahhud.
Wallahu a'lam, sallallahu ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.